is Bloomberg UTV.
Hello and welcome to Life in Style. This is the show that redefines fashion and fills you in on all that's hot and happening in fashion, fitness, and fun. On the show this week, we start off with an exotic location to soak in some royalty in Jodhpur. Also on the show, we give you tips on how to stay cool in a business suit this summer with the right fit and look. In health and fitness, we'll tell you how to samba your way to a fit and fab body and let tea, the new age beverage, be the right chiller for you this summer. Visiting Rajasthan is always a great experience, and in Jodhpur you can find such a lot of history and culture. But what if you're traveling through the Blue City for just one day? Well, Khushbu Patodia tells you exactly what you must check out.
That cool blue spread, you must have seen a lot of it on screen, more recently in Abhay Deol's starrer Road movie. The Blue City, Jodhpur, is a happy hunting ground for lensmen for its picture postcard beauty. One day is not enough to soak in all the experiences that the city has on offer. But if you have precisely one day, here are some things that you must not miss.
We've reached 150 meters uphill at the Mehrangarh Fort. Now, if you're in Jodhpur, you cannot give this fort a miss. It's the most magnificent and secured forts in the entire Rajasthan. The height of the fort actually lets you see the entire city from here.
Built by Rajput chief Rao Jodha in 1459, the Mehrangarh Fort is majestic, as royal forts ought to be. Spectacular carved doors and window panels, a fabulous collection of the Queen's palanquins and royal furniture. It's like taking a close peek at the secret lives of the erstwhile royalty. Singularly unique sights and sounds tell you that you can't be anywhere else in the world but in Rajasthan. Then what's a fort without cannons? These cannons take you back to the days when honor and valor were as much part of the royal lifestyle as opulence and luxury. By now, I was so hungry that I could have had a camel. Well, not quite. I took a quick snack break at Mishri Lal's, located in the biggest local market of Jodhpur, the Sardar Market.
Now, whether or not you have a sweet tooth, you must try the Makhaniya Lassi and the Mewa Kachori. The Lassi comes with a rich butter topping. It's not very sweet, but at the same time, very filling. I think I'm surely going to go back with some extra calories.
Eating done, your Jodhpur tour is obviously incomplete without shopping in this city of handicrafts and textiles. So that's what I did next. Colourful block printed and embroidered bed sheets, home decoration items, there was so much to choose from. I laid my hands on some pretty beanbag covers for as less as 250 rupees.
While in Jodhpur, the traditional Jodhpuri muddas are not to be given a miss. These are sewed by women and children in small-scale industries. They are a must-buy. I'm going to pick one of them.
Jodhpur is best experienced only when you have some time on your hand. But now you know you can pack in quite a lot even in one day, just as I did. Khushbu Patodia, Bloomberg UTV, Mumbai.
That was a slice of the exotic, but if you're someone who loves the outdoors or loves to go out camping but thinks it's too much of a mess or too much of a hassle, here's what we propose: that you go out camping in relative luxury at the Big Red Tent.
The name The Big Red Tent sounds like a leftist party's convention or even a new age commune. Thankfully, it's neither. Offering an escape from the urban grind, the Big Red Tent is a convenient solution for all your camping needs. 2 hours away from Mumbai, the Big Red Tent promises a complete outdoor experience, making it a strong contender for your next weekend getaway. Situated at the end of a 40-acre farm property along the river Batsa in Shahapur, the Big Red Tent combines the best of both worlds, comfort and adventure.
I think they've taken a few elements of what you get in a hotel and put it into the nature, onto the grounds and within the trees.
Apart from the basic creature comforts, the campsite provides you with a host of outdoor activities and that elusive commodity forever in short supply in our cities, solitude. It's a great place to go and unwind after a stressful week at work or indulge in some good old hangout time with your entire gang. The common areas are equipped with plenty of board games and books to keep you busy.
You can also exercise those restless feet with a trek around the campsite, or you can just soak in the river like I did.
The other big attraction is the barbecue, where you can make an occasion out of your meal.
Okay, this is the first time I'm ever pitching a tent and I'm a bit nervous, but I hear it's super simple. It's almost idiot-proof. Now, that should be really easy, so Mukesh is going to help me out with this one.
That was easy, but all that work makes you relish your bed and sleep all the more. A double occupancy tent comes for ₹1,200 per person per night, while an additional person can hop on in the same tent for ₹1,000 extra. And this package does not include food. You could toss up your own meals, or if you're in a real lazy state of mind, you can order in from the local restaurant.
It's been a long day and I'm ready to call it a night, and what a wonderful experience to be camping out. And to be camping out in such comfort has even higher perks. Well, for now, I'm ready to zip this tent up. What a great way to enjoy the outdoors, right? In complete comfort. Well, for right now, we're going into a short break, but when we come back, we'll tell you how to increase your style quotient the Italian way. And after that, we have some shining tips for your home.